Hello, hello.
Yeah.
Does it work?
Cool.
So my name is actually Bartłomiej Górny. This is not the right size, sorry. Yeah. I work for Erlang Solutions. I'm one of the co-developers of MangVM, which is an XMPP server for instant messaging written in Erlang. Before we start, I need to make an important disclaimer. There might be some people from XMPP Software Standards Foundation in the room. Those are the guys that know XMPP inside out. So I need to say a few words to them. Guys, please excuse me. I will be taking some liberties with the protocol. I need to take some shortcuts, simplify things a bit to make the talk concise and understandable. You might suffer. If you really need to kill me, please do it after the talk. We're going to talk about innovation. What innovation actually is. There are two kinds of novel things. There's invention, there's innovation. The formal definition of them is that invention is something really new, some new idea, some new project, some new design. And innovation is actually an implementation of an invention. So, it may take a while to read this, because this is the formal philosophical definition of that. In short, ideas, inventions change the world. Innovation puts the ideas into motion, makes them real. So in our case, invention would be something new that we want to do using instant messaging, some new service, some new ways to use it. And innovation would be implementation of those. So, or alternatively, innovation can be new way to do something that already existed, some old idea which is done in an innovative way. So in our case, it's going to be extension of a protocol, right? That's what we are going to talk about. How can we innovate using this protocol of ours? There is a trap about extending stuff. Because the protocol is extensible. That's part of its name, right? So it's easy to extend. But being easy to extend is far from enough. For example, Drupal, the CMS written in PHP, pretty well recognized. It's very extensible. And the result is that the homepage of Drupal hosts slightly above 22,000 extensions. So good luck trying to use them, right? The good thing about XMPP is that it's under control. There's a standard foundation which takes care of it. If you want to do something new in the protocol, there's a standardization procedure, which is not easy to pass. It takes a long time. And the result is that it's not 22,000, but about 150 current officially supported extensions. And they usually don't overlap. If you want to do something, you probably find just one extension that does this. If there are two, one of them is usually deprecated. So let's go. Who's familiar with XMPP? Right, about half of the people. So that would be a crash course for beginners and a quick refresher for the other half of the population of the Zoom. This is a client-server-server-client protocol because usually it's clients communicate via server, but it supports federation. So clients can use different servers in different domains and the messages are passed through them. In some quite corner cases, clients communicate directly, but we're not going to cover this one. Now, XMPP works by sending stanzas, so-called. Stanza is an XML structure, and there are three types of stanzas. And there will never be more than three types of stanzas. You cannot innovate by creating new type of stanza. There's IQ, which has little to do with intelligence. It stands for info query. And this is normally used for communicating between client and server. If you want to set some configuration parameters of your account, or if you want to draw messages from your archive, use IQ. There's a presence, which is normally handled by server based on data provided by client. So sometimes client can send presents like I'm busy, and this gets distributed to the friends of this client. And sometimes if this client loses connections, then server automatically says this guy is unavailable and distributes presents to other clients. And messages are, again, normally just shipped from client to client. Server does not do much with the internals of the message. It's just like, it's opaque for the server. This said, right, and how does the stanza look like? This is a typical message that Bernardo can send to Francisco in Verona or somewhere else in Italy. This is the name of the message. This is its type. It's addressed from to. Often messages have ID, which should be unique. And this is the inside the stanza. This is just a body of a message. This is the most simple stanza you can possibly do. There are a few predefined types, which are also like non-modifiable. For IQ is get, set, result, or error. So if you set some parameters, you send set stanza, you get result okay, or error. If you get, you get result like your messages from an archive. For presence, it can be empty. Empty presence is I'm available, or unavailable, and so on and so on. I mean, I could talk about XMPP till Thursday, so we are just going to skim through along the surface. Messages are normal messages, which is just one-to-one message to someone. Chat is a part of a longer conversation. Group chat is, well, group chat. Now, what's inside the stanza? Inside the stanza are things that are, there's a payload which is processed by server or by client or by both, hopefully by somebody. So this is, for example, a simple presence, which has, it may be empty. Empty presence is just I'm available, right? There can be more. For example, this is this stands for do not disturb. This is some short comment. I'm on a call. So if your instant messaging client receives something like this, it probably will show you some little stop sign, like do not disturb, and this line underneath. And this is call protocol. This is defined in very basic documents. This is global namespace. Nothing fancy in this. And pay attention, because this is the most important slide of the whole presentation. An element can introduce its own namespace. For example, this is what we had before, right? We just show you I'm on a call, do not disturb me. And then we have something like mood, annoyed, and text, which basically, mood has no meaning in the global namespace. Text is ambiguous, what a text is. But this element introduces its own namespace. And within this namespace, stuff like mood, annoyed, and text are defined. So your Jabber client will show you somehow, one way or another, that the guy is annoyed and whatever. Or if your client does not support this namespace, you just ignore it. And this is actually an extension to the protocol. This is called XEP, XMPP extension proposal. And we can use alternatively feature, extension, XEP, and namespace, because this is exactly the same thing. Every feature is defined in XEP, and every feature has its own namespace. So, all right. Because every feature has a namespace, then if we ask a server, for example, what can you do for us? What features do you support? It replies by sending us a list of namespaces, which is basically which maps one-to-one to the list of XEPs that this server implements. So this in XMPP parlance, this is how we call it. And this is, by the way, another XEP, which is service discovery. All right, so this is the namespace of service discovery, disco info, and this is the server's reply. I need to rush because there's quite a few slides ahead. Namespaces can be nested, because there can be namespaces within namespace. The deepest nesting I found so far was 3 levels. It was Jingle negotiating a file transfer. This is actually a honking great idea, because it makes things very, very easy to implement. You have an XML structure, you just iterate deeper into this. If you find namespace, you can hook a callback for it to handle this namespace. If there's no callback, then just skip it, and this is done. So this can make code very orderly. And you can play with message payload however you want. For example, this is just a message saying, I send you something in a while. So we receive this message, and the other guy keeps typing. And our client shows us, like, he is typing, or some icon or whatever. Every IAM client does this. This is because we receive this message, which has no body. It doesn't have to. But it uses another extension, chat state notifications. I told you there are 115 extensions, so there's quite a few things to talk about. This is chat states, and chat states define composing state, which means what it means, right? The guy is typing. So there's a lot of freedom in it. Right. XMPP is very well documented. This is because those XSF guys are really tough, and they demand very good XEPs. So their RFC defines basic features, and there are those enhancement proposals. They all look pretty much the same, because the format and the style of writing has to be the same all the time. So there are hundreds of them, because it's not only extensions. XEPs define formats of address, lots of stuff, or best practices. They're pretty verbose, which takes a while getting used to, but it's a matter of personal preference, if somebody likes it or not. They are all listed on the website. And the most important XEP of all, XEP 0001, which tells us how to write XEPs. So it's sort of a meta XEP, if you will. Now, to the point. What if you want to extend the protocol? And how do we go about it? First thing is read existing XEPs. Really, because it's very rare that somebody comes up with an idea that has not been already covered. But it happens. The good thing about them is they're really bulletproof. And, I mean, there are dozens of people who read them and discuss them for a year or longer before they get finally accepted. You are likely to find an extension that you can extend. Because, as I said, you can nest namespaces. So you can put extension within extension. And to give you an example, let's say you had an idea that chat state can tell more about someone. Because chat state tells us that somebody is typing. But it doesn't tell us how he is typing. Is he nervous, typing very fast? Or is he just slowly, letter by letter, watching TV or corner of his eye? This is very easy to do it in client, right? To measure typing speed. So, but we already have chat state, right? We don't have to do it from scratch. We have chat state. So this is actually nothing that would stop us from doing this. This guy is furious. He's typing like 500 characters per minute. So this is our extension. No official number, read chat state notification, namespace, and this is what we do. And we do it furiously, lazily, sloppily, whatever, nervous. The syntax is different, but namespace is just arbitrary string. So this is old syntax, this is the new, the currently preferred. Oh my god. Choose a stanza. For client server is IQ, for client is message. Do not use presence. Why? Presence is generating too much. It's very tempting to use presence. I will show it in a while. Presence generates very much traffic. 80% of instant messaging traffic is presences, not messages. They go to everybody whether you want it or not. And there are much better ways to do that. For example, let's say you have an idea that you want to provide geolocation of a client. The client can be a physical person or a device mounted somewhere on a truck or wherever. So the first idea is, well, it's presence, right? This guy is present at a certain location. So what can be more obvious than using presence for this? So when I first thought about this, this was my first idea. And I thought, well, I'm so smart. It's so obvious. I know the spirit of XMPP. It's presence. So doing something like this. Presence, we insert location element. Done, right? No. And there are at least three reasons not to do it this way. First, as I mentioned, location goes to everybody. So every one of your friends will be flooded by your presences carrying location, whether he wants it or not. And there's no way to get rid of it. Because he wants to get your presence, but not necessarily location. He doesn't want like five presences per minute showing him that you are riding a motorcycle or whatever. And it's not archive, which is something that we might want in this case. Reason number two is that there is a very neat thing. It's called personal eventing protocol. Because there is PubSub, which is publish subscribe. There can be a node, you subscribe to the node, you get information. If the server implements XEP 0163, it means that it supports personal eventing protocol, which basically means that every user is a PubSub node. So you can subscribe to events generated by this person. So now the location would go only to people who really want it, because they subscribed to it. And the guy has a control over who gets his location and who doesn't. And reason number three, arguably the most important, is that it's already done. So that's why it's recommended to read or accept before thinking about anything else. Then free your mind. Because there's, you can put anything you like in the stanza, provided you obey certain rules. Then you have, of course, design sequences. Like, if the server receives this stanza, then it must reply with something, or error, and so on, and so on, and so on. It's highly recommended to write ZEPs, because it makes you think again about what you've done or what you're about to do. It's good to have it because it's consistent. So if your developer read 70 XEPs from the core protocol, it would be easier for him to read another one written in the same fashion. And try to have it approved. It will get rejected, but you will get some feedback. Now, we've actually done this a few times. Yeah, I know, I have 1 minute, right? Okay. I have two slides, 1 minute. Secret message. Somebody wants to send messages that are handled differently. This is actually a real life case. So again, the first idea is message type, right? There's chat, there's secret chat. No, don't do this, you'll break everything. This is the way to do this. Insert another namespace, flag the message as secret. So the server, a piece of cake to implement it on the server, client can also handle it easily. And the other one is MookLite, which I would very much like to tell everybody a lot, but you can do it afterwards. It's a simplified lightweight version of multi-user chat. Because multi-user chat is more scalable. We submitted it to XSF 2 years ago, and we are still trying to have it approved. Chances are slim. But we are not giving up. And we use it in production on many sites. So it's more or less proven to work. Thank you very much. I really have to finish.
Approaches, if you are a speaker, try to get closer to this area so we don't lose much time if we get late with some sessions. And also as a speaker, try